Rishi, you kind of heard my explanation and my reaction to both Meyer and Cobalt. What is yours?
Yeah, and thanks so much for having me. Really appreciate it. I'm actually here in New York at RBC's Global Tech Conference. And as you can imagine, generative AI is front and center in all our conversations. And look, one of the themes that we hear from a lot of companies is it is prohibitively expensive to do generative AI, right? Not just the training, but the inferencing, trying to add domain expertise, connecting all these different systems. And so what I think Microsoft brings here is they can help themselves and other companies overcome this big GPU shortage that's out there. As you said, the specs aren't quite the same exactly as an A100, but I think what's interesting is you don't necessarily need only A100s to do all your training, especially if you're thinking about, you know, more domain-specific models or trying to do some, you know, additional tooling on top of GPT-4 or Llama 2. And so this creates, I think, more accessibility for large language models, for software companies, for industry companies to embrace generative AI without seeing that huge cost drag. So I'm really excited to see this news. This is something that we suspected for a long time, but I think it is ultimately going to make Gen AI more accessible.
TSMC, I think, making the chips Arm sort of behind from a technology perspective. But I'm interested, Rishi, as to what this does mean for competitors. Amazon's already been doing this. Alphabet's Google has already been doing this with their cloud provisions. Does it who does it impact? It feels like maybe Intel's the one to be watching.
Yeah, look, I think it impacts everyone, right? I think, we're going to have to see how the specs between AWS's chips and GCP's chips and Microsoft chips compare. But Microsoft has already this kind of pole position as being the leader when it comes to enterprise generative AI. And I think this only bolsters that, that companies now know that they can go to Microsoft and they may not need to go to someone like Oracle that has excess GPU capacity. They can stick with Microsoft because now Microsoft has the capacity, given they've shown the ability to develop this in-house. So this is probably, I think, positive for Microsoft. Probably it's going to be, as you said, there are absolutely direct implications for Intel, for AMD, for others within the chip space. But overall, I think this is just going to be positive for Microsoft and OpenAI.
It's so interesting to see where some of these names are trading right now. Intel's up 2% in the session. Caro makes such a good point that this battleground seems like the lower end of the accelerator market. I'm looking specifically at Microsoft though, right, Rishi? That's why we're here. It's down 0.2%. It's kind of like a muted reaction. Does that signal that this just isn't a game changer for Microsoft's cloud business? Like, why is there not a more significant reaction in the stock here?
Yeah, look, I think the jury is still out, right? As you correctly pointed out, the specs aren't exactly up to the top of the line GPUs from NVIDIA. And, you know, given Microsoft's pace of innovation, perhaps investors were expecting something like that. I think Microsoft will eventually get there. I think they've shown they have the ability to innovate and move very quickly. And that might explain why there's maybe a little bit of a muted reaction. I'll also say beyond the chips, some of the product announcements we've seen so far out of Ignite may not be as exciting as people were hoping to see. I think, in my view, there's a lot of exciting stuff that we're already seeing. And, you know, obviously, as Satya's keynote is about to kick off, I think we're going to see a lot more. So I wouldn't be surprised as the conference and the day goes on, Microsoft stock actually moves up, assuming that they continue to make, you know, I think announcements that excite people, give some stats around M365 adoption. I really like that they've rebranded Bing Enterprise Chat as Microsoft Copilot. I think that makes it a much more digestible, kind of straightforward value proposition. And I think this just opens up a lot of innovation from Microsoft.
Rishi, as we do anticipate what Satya is going to say on stage, it is interesting that it looks like it's the price that is becoming front and center now. We had that with OpenAI's Developers Day as well. It all seemed to be suddenly a bit of a race to offer more and accessibility and GPTs and chats, as we're seeing more assistance, but with a cheaper price point, a new lower price for clients, for example, Microsoft 365 Copilot product for the Office software and the Sales Copilot. Is that going to be a bit of a rush downwards, do you think, in the price point of all of these?
I actually don't think so. In fact, I would argue, going to OpenAI, $20 a month is actually too cheap for what you're getting out of ChatGPT-4, assuming you're a power user, which I would consider myself to be one of those. For Microsoft Copilot, the name of the game here is not about lowering the price. It's about adding new features and adding new capabilities. And so now, you know, with the announcements today, what used to be called Bing Enterprise Chat, now is Microsoft Copilot, is part of that $30 per user per month that was in the M365 SKU that got released earlier this month. You also have connectivity of M365 Copilot to systems of record like ServiceNow and Workday. And so to me, as long as Microsoft continues to grow what is included in that SKU, in that $30 per user per month, I think people are going to be able to justify that price pretty easily. And look no further than GitHub Copilot. GitHub Copilot has been the most mature generative AI product for Microsoft. It's been, you know, I think a slam dunk in terms, if you look at the metrics in terms of developer productivity, new code generation. And I wouldn't be surprised if we start to see the same out of M365 Copilot as they continue to innovate. You know, maybe for an Excel junkie like me, we'll get an Excel Copilot that makes my life of building financial models and doing data analysis a lot easier over the next year. So really the name of the game is going to be innovation and adding more features, not lowering price.